What are you building?
Our little sanctuary revival project has really helped. It takes my mind off things.
At least it's not raining.
I can rest easy knowing that Wolfgang is rotten in hell. Thank you. Do you need anything?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
A little bit of everything.
Seems to be growing well.
Where'd you go?
Damn. Not afraid of mutants, huh? You're our kind of guy.
Angel!
What do you mean you can't open the gate? Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
Shh. Play along.
What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Another great day in Diamond City.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrapped for parts.
So,
tyrant mayor,
you're that traitor Piper was talking about.
Why don't we ask the newcomer?
Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again.
Free speech in the dumpster.
Right?
You're Sullivan, right?
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again. Am I right?
I didn't mean to lie, officer. It all just happened so fast.
Oh, sure it did.
I didn't mean to lie.
You're not the first guy Piper pulled into a heap of trouble he wasn't ready for. Thanks for being honest. If it were up to me, we would have just let the both of you in. But the mayor's calling the shots, and, well, you saw how mad he is. Hey, what's brought you into town anyway? Be good to note it down in the logs.
I'm trying to find someone.
Is that so? Who are you looking for?
My boy Sean's been kidnapped. He's just a baby.
Oh, look, I'm sorry, but we're under orders not to get involved in missing person cases. There's a lot of institute paranoia right now. We can't really risk fanning those flames with official action. What if people panic?
I just need a little information, Danny. We can keep this off the record.
Okay. I can at least point you somewhere. Unofficially. When you get inside the city, go to the back, around the market, to an alleyway. There's a couple of bright neon signs. Valentine's Detective Agency. No one likes going there, though, so buyer beware and all that.
People don't like the detective agency?
Look, all I can tell you is that we hear a lot of complaints.
Thanks for your help.
Yeah, well, good luck. Stay out of trouble.
Hey, Sullivan.
Just walk on through the gate if you need to leave.
What's up?
Head on inside.
Officer?
Got a question? Should talk to Sullivan.
kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper? Is the Institute spying on your home? Read the public to find out. Free paper to newcomers. If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
I'm glad you dropped by. You holding up, Blue?
Yeah, holding up.
Look, I'm just gonna say it. You're a vault dweller. You might not be wearing the blue jumpsuit, but the Pip-Boy and that fish out of water look? Dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
The war? Which war?
The one that gave us this lovely landscape of demolished buildings and nuclear radiation every 10 feet? You're telling me you saw everything before they blasted it into pieces?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
I've been having too much fun blowing things up to think about it.
Gotta make my job hard for me, huh? All right, if that's the quote, that's the quote. Now, the big question. Why come to Diamond City? You're looking for someone, aren't you? Who is it?
You heard wrong. I'm not looking for anyone.
Don't lie to me, Blue. This is your story. Don't you want people to know the truth?
I lost family, okay? I'm trying to get one of them back.
What's their name, Blue? Who are they?
My son, Sean, was kidnapped. He's not even a year old.
The parent after the missing child. As heartbreaking today as it ever was. Tell me, do you suspect the Institute's involved?
The Institute? Who were they?
That, Blue, is the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth. No one really knows who or where they are, but their handiwork is all over. Synths. Synthetic people. Sent from their hidden labs to do the Institute's dirty work. Sometimes they even replace a person with a synth double. A little covert agent no one would ever suspect. Now, not everything that goes wrong has the Institute behind it, but there's always a chance. That's why I'm asking.
They make synthetic people?
That's right. There are two major kinds you have to watch out for. The first is an obvious fake. Skin looks like plastic, skeleton might even be showing. You see groups of them scouring the Commonwealth, killing people and scavenging what's left. I reported on University Point a while back. Whole town got cleaned out. The second type of synth is the real deal. With skin, blood, warm smiles and guilty glances, just like a good old-fashioned human. So do you think they could be involved? The Institute or one of their agents?
Sure sounds like they might be.
Not even a baby is safe from them. And people wonder why I can't just look the other way. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
Wait, people just ignore kidnappings out here?
Yeah, Blue, you haven't noticed? You grow up in the Commonwealth and eventually someone is gonna get taken. Maybe not someone you know, but someone. And people just say, well, could have been worse. Could have been killed by raider attacks or super mutants or feral ghouls. They just give up. So I want my readers to hear what keeps you going. Maybe they'll find a little inspiration. Now, what would you like to say?
Find who's responsible and make them pay. Simple as that.
I'll take anger over apathy any day. Good quote. Thanks, Blue. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next. Let me know if there's anything I can do to lighten the load, or, you know, if you need anything proofread.